Hey guys, it's Cremed.Mofen here today with another vid, and today I'm gonna make another vid with Cremed.Mofen. I'm going to be going France, as you can see, and he's going to be going either England or the UK, and we're both just gonna be going communist. I got a mod on that makes me that makes my French focus tree a lot bigger, so that way I can actually achieve this. So you know what, let's just start it off. Basically, we are not going to let Germany walk all over us and remilitarize that Rhineland. We're just going to go straight at war with them. Okay guys, so I'm basically just going to grab all my mountaineers and reserve divisions and all the bad divisions, just put them straight on the Italian border. So I'm just going to start training up. Right now, you already saw the focus I first selected. We're just going to go straight communist. It won't be the best idea, but it'll actually, we need to do it. You might be thinking, why not do the industrialization? Because that won't be what we need. What we need, we just need to go. So I'm just going to, you know, get ready, and yeah. So right now I just put in all my tanks into one thing, and put all of my stuff. Any mobile divisions are going to go under this guy. That includes cavalry, tanks. They're all going under this guy. Okay, right now our army is about two divisions big, so we're gonna take this guy, put it in this army, and take this guy right here, and put him in also in this army. This army is going to be the Italian border army, just in case Italy gets any ideas. I don't need to put a high level general. I just need to put some really low, bad one that no one even knew existed. Like, if you weren't France, you wouldn't know he existed. And yeah, Mountaineer too. Wow, this guy is just absolutely amazing. We'll just put him like right here. We'll then just start building some, you know, some, not in Paris, because, you know, we have a bad history. Let's put him in Normandy, because a certain invasion happened there. Start upgrading our subs, because, you know, we need to get those as high as possible. And we still have some unassigned divisions. We still have 7 unassigned divisions. And, well, no, we still have a lot of unassigned divisions. I just forgot to assign my infantry. That was almost a mistake. So I'm just gonna, you know, just scroll up. Let's find a nice general. This one's probably gonna be a good one. You know, let's just put all of these guys straight on that German border. You know, I'm gonna put these guys taking the north. Yeah. So as you can see right now, I'm going to title this Africa and put them on the lowest priority, because Africa really does not matter. Because on like an odd timeline in this one, Italy's going to have absolutely no chance at pushing me back. Where is this guy? Over here. You'll also be joining the African Front. You guys, all of you, will be joining that African Front. You'll also be joining the African Front. And you'll also be joining that nice, nice African Front. You're also in Africa? Join the African Front? Well, that is almost an entire full army just of divisions just in Africa. That is going to absolutely take out Italy. Let's put this guy straight on aggro. And let's start uniting on Navy. I just want this Navy to be as big as possible on this front, and 37 ships, we need to just, you know, like, just make all of this ready to fight the Italian Navy, because the German Navy is a joke. There's three whole ships. That's a lot of ships right there. Let's have them all at this point. I'm ready when you are. Okay, so right now we have low manpower. How many men do we have in the field? 570,000. That is huge. I'm saying right now I could probably just take out Germany's Hitler by myself. So basically, I'm just going to, you know, sit here and wait for Germany to try to remilitarize that Rhineland and be the exact opposite of France. Right now we're just gonna go ask England to what does that mean? Let's just offer them some nice military access. Cause you know, we just need to make sure that they can't make any excuses whatsoever. So yep, right now this is looking pretty nice. Basically, since we have the larger army, we want to make this as big as possible. The larger the army, the better. So basically, we're just going to be, you know, sitting here for a little while. You also want to have control of the English Channel. So, as you can see right now, this is not looking too good for our enemies, because we are just stacked on their border. We have more divisions on their border than they have in their entire army. And that is the point we want to be at. We have 3 military factories. We only have 7 military factories, but we don't need that much. We don't need that many in Africa, so I'm just going to take out the bad divisions, so basically all of them almost. I'm going to take out like 4, discard these 4 African divisions, and there we go, that's 3 manpower, and look at that, that's 3,000 less guns than we need to actually create. Unfortunate, we just lost my general, he's sick, he's not used to that weather. We are gaining 0 political power per day. That is very, very bad. National mobilization. Commune conservation. Scientific cooperation. The fascist threat. So I could either, I have two options. I could either take down England, or I could take down Germany. And since England is a good little buddy of mine, I feel like Germany's days are numbered. I need some political. A D-Day on Germany, not D-Day on Germany. They're going to, you know, actually, yeah, no, go D-Day on Germany. Invade Hamburger. Hanover, Bremen, yeah, you see Hamburg, Bremen, and Wilsum. Invade those three. And so about my pronunciation, I am not German, so I don't have good pronunciation of these states. If you know how to pronounce them, just tell me, and yeah. Invade Brandenburg. No, invade Hamburg first. Hamburg is the biggest target. Invade Hamburg and cut off the German armies in the far north bordering Denmark. So as you can see right now, I can't do a focus because of this. So I'm just going to be sitting here waiting. Hamburg? Okay, you see that? Okay, scroll out. You see German Reich? Right, you see Berlin? You see how there's the star for the capital? Okay, you see like how there's like the point with a star? Like, you know how there's like the topmost and a thing most to the left? You see that little meeting point? Draw like a diagonal line to the nearest to that port that's like diagonally away. You see to its left? It's like comes in that little like alcove. No, like the city. The city is Hamburg, but the province is Hanover. Yeah. Guys, this video's gone on for about 12 minutes, so I feel like this is a good point to say, like, subscribe, so that way you can not miss, and no, hit that bell. Don't forget to hit that bell. I almost forgot to tell you that. So that way you don't miss any more of this prime content produced by me. Because the more subs we get, the more I'll edit these videos, and make them a lot more enjoyable to watch than this mediocre that I have right now. So the more people that watch, the more effort I'll put in. And yeah. Right now, as you can see, I'm just kind of like building that communist support. As you can see, I have the feeling that I should probably send some volunteers to Republican Spain. So, where's that send volunteers? Oh, I can't. Oh, no, that's not good. Let's go to details. Oh, no, looks like we're going to have a fascist at our southern border. But you know what? That's okay. That is okay, because once Germany completes... Oh, they don't look too keen to go down that Rhineland. Let them build up all they want. Me and you will still be able to crush them with our combined armies. As you can see right now, France starts off in a really bad spot. We're under economic collapse, and the communists just need to come in and take control. If the communists come in, their centralized economy will, again, make this country great again. I mean, I have a 10 level fortification wall on their border. I do feel a little like Trump. Think about it though, this is mountains with a wall. Use this mountains means the fortifications are gonna, let's say they're not breaking through this tile. They can have whatever they want. This tile is going to cause them probably, let's say, a million guys to break through this one tile. And then it'll just be theirs, because we will have no chance of taking it back. Once it gets to 75 political power, I'm just going to call it. And do I have a silent workhorse? I do have a silent workhorse. But I'm going to get this one, which is absolutely amazing. It's called Political Effort. It's part of the mod. So yeah. So guys, right now, we're just kind of in this little build-up phase. Let's see if Germany tries doing that. Germany just did Vineland. Let's make social, we can't, social reforms. Let's make social reforms. It's going to absolutely ruin our economy. But you know what? It's okay. It is 110% okay. We just need to start building up more and more guns, because we are heavily lacking in that. And yeah, so guys, if you want to think of a way for us to invade and take out Germany, I realize Germany did Ostwall. Those are level 3 forts. I'm very worried about that. Sorry about that little disappearance. I had to go do something. Okay, so I'm back. And again, my bad. I shouldn't have gone like that. Germany is not attacking me for some reason. Well, I could just probably just take him out right now if I really wanted to. Okay, we're gonna do rearmament because we need that right now. We need to get, I don't have the political power. I don't have the war support to get to early mobilization, so you know. And I just opened up the Pickle Discourse. And my communist support is actually doing fairly well right now. It's going to take us a long, long time. I'm just going to be doing frank devaluation because I need political power. My communist support is about 33%. So basically, I'm just gonna keep, you know, looking to build up. The Germans don't really perceive me to be much of a threat because they have a small border with me. Because the Germans have still not done Rhineland. I think me being on their border with plans to invade them is scaring them. And Africa? I mean, you have so much land, you're probably gonna... Yeah, these provinces have like millions. Uganda has a population of 3 million. Uganda has the same amount of population as Sudan. But it's only like one-fourth of the size. One-fourth, like one-tenth of the size. No. Class. Oh yeah, let's go. My communist support. Just absolutely shot up to 39%. And let's just say that is huge.
Please clap.
Okay guys, so I feel like 25 minutes is a good enough for a build-up video. I don't want it to be too boring. So if this wasn't your style of video, just tune in for the next one. It's going to come out, I'd say, in about like a few hours. Because we're just going to keep playing the series. Alright, as of now, we have like 41% communist support, and that is absolutely massive. We're going to be communist in the next vid, and then we're going to be able to build up. I'm just calling it. Make sure if you haven't done so already, like, subscribe, tell your friends, tell anyone about this nice channel that I've started up, so that way I can get subs, and I can start actually committing to this nice little YouTube thing, making these videos better. That's just if you enjoy them. If you don't, well, still try. Make sure you leave that like. Okay, bye.